The Trump campaign has compiled a list of what it says are voting irregularities in Nevada. But this list, this is it right here, this may actually be just all of the military voters and other Americans who legally cast their ballots from out of state or out of country, and that includes from war zones. So let's take a look at what's in this list, which was obtained by the Nevada Independent, that the Weir Law Firm, on behalf of the Trump campaign, flagged to the Justice Department. I know that this is a lot to follow, but that is what the campaign is banking on, that you won't. So stick with us here on this. In this information on more than 3,000 Nevada voters, you'll see a telltale abbreviation for a number of forwarding addresses, APO and FPO. That is short for Army Post Office or Fleet Post Office. These are post offices for the armed forces. And if you've ever sent mail to a deployed service member or one who's stationed overseas, you're going to recognize that abbreviation. For context, when my kids and I sent my husband care packages while he was deployed to Afghanistan recently, we sent it to an APO. You don't just send the mail to Afghanistan or to Germany or wherever when it's going to a military base. And in this list, there are 130 times that an APO appears in this list. And you can see that there is a state listed, AE. Well, that's actually not a state at all, as you know. And it's a wonder that a lawyer didn't catch that and Google it and discover that it stands for Armed Forces in Europe, the Middle East, Africa, or Canada. Or there's also AP listed as a state in some of these cases, Armed Forces in the Pacific. That's what that means. There's also DPO, which is Diplomatic Post Office. That is for diplomats serving overseas. These are Americans serving their countries. They're already jumping through the hoops of voting absentee, and they now appear to be flagged for possibly committing voter fraud. Voters with addresses on military bases are in this list. Joint Base Andrews, JBER, that is Joint Base Elmendorf-Richardson in Alaska. There's Fort Bragg, North Carolina. And by the way, we go through these pages and pages, and we also found voters that the Trump campaign flagged to have home addresses on other bases like Beale Air Force Base, Hill Air Force Base, Joint Base Pearl Harbor Hickam, Travis Air Force Base, Fort Belvoir, and there's really so many more. This goes on and on. Most military families, though, keep in mind, they actually live off base. They're in civilian communities near military bases like Tyler, Texas, Abilene, Texas, Oak Harbor, Washington, Norfolk, Virginia, all of which appear over and over on this list, along with other cities that are near military installations. So it seems very likely that these voters listed here did not actually commit voter fraud. But Trump campaign lawyers have characteristically muddied the waters, which is really the whole point here, right? Maximizing the confusion, the Weir Law Firm did not list the actual addresses or names of the voters. That would, of course, be an even bigger violation of privacy than this list already is. But it also has the effect of making it harder to connect the dots. Instead, the Trump campaign identified voters by using detailed zip codes, 5 digits plus the extra 4 that denote a more exact location of the Nevada resident's out-of-state address. And that's been enough for some military families to locate themselves on this list. We asked the Nevada Republican Party and the Trump campaign about this, and we did hear back from the Trump campaign from a spokesperson who told us this, quote, "Due to privacy concerns, we have not shared and will not share the list of names with the public. We have no way to confirm whether a small number of these voters fall under an exemption, which is why we referred it to the authorities for further investigation. All valid voters' votes should be counted." Well, that statement, as my grandpa would say, is pucky. The Trump campaign and its lawyers won't share the names of those voters with us, but they know them, and they could easily confirm if these active duty military family members are on this list. I mean, I could do that in a second. They just don't want to. And not to mention, voting from one's home of record while serving the United States of America is not an exemption, as the Trump campaign describes it. It is a right. It's not some special privilege to allow service members, their families, or others who are serving their country away from home to vote.